Sheik made her Smash debut in Super Smash Bros. Melee, sharing a character slot with Zelda. The two could transform into one another using their down specials, much like Pokemon Trainer, to reflect the transformation between Zelda and Sheik in Ocarina of Time. Zelda is far worse than Sheik in competitive Melee, so most players just stick to Sheik. Her amazing tech chases and forward air KOs make her a top tier character who was once considered to be the best in the game, and she's still relevant in top tier metagame play to this day. Brawl nerfed Sheik heavily, taking away most of what made her strong in Melee, so the character was rarely seen in that game. In Smash 4, Sheik was finally separated from Zelda, giving them each their own character slots and a new down special. Sheik received the Bouncing Fish for her down special, a quick dive forward that kicks opponents and bounces off of them. This move was one of many buffs that took Sheik in the new and good direction. Unlike hard-hitting forward air she had in Melee, Smash 4 made Sheik's fare much weaker, but an amazing combo tool. With this, Sheik could rack up early percent damage without her Melee tech chases by carrying characters across the stage with fare. She could set up fare as well as many other aerials from her throws, and could even combo into up air from throws at kill percent. Smash 4 also replaced her somewhat useless chain attack side B with a burst grenade, which I suppose was situational in its own use. After his main Diddy Kong was nerfed, World Number 1 Zero used Sheik in many matchups throughout his peak in Smash 4. He eventually dropped the character when her back air, bouncing fish, needles, and throws were all nerfed, but Void and Mr. R continued to perform well with Sheik, with Void even winning a major at Smash and Splash. On the surface, Ultimate didn't change Sheik much from Smash 4, but her results have dropped off significantly. This is until Frostbite. But before we get into that, ProGuides.com is the place to be to expand your Smash knowledge. We've got tier lists, character guides, and instant access to coaches with our Play With Pros platform. If that wasn't enough, you can learn from the best via exclusive pro courses featuring MKLeo, Zero, and more. Void was a prominent top player in Smash 4, well known as one of the two best Sheik mains after Zero dropped the character. He gained some initial success in Smash Ultimate with Pichu, but faded into obscurity in tournaments for a while after Pichu was nerfed. Lately, he has been making an effort to get back to his legacy main, Sheik, using the character at the recent major tournament, Frostbite. The spotlight was on Void as he faced off against Japan's best player, Zach Ray, using Sheik. Sheik was considered to be mid-tier by many players, even low-tier by some, and Zach Ray's starting pick of Mr. Game & Watch far outclassed the Nimble Ninja in terms of results. The results and tier opinions meant nothing to Void. However, as he took game one in a JV two-stock fashion with a down tilt to Smash confirm, Zachary opted to switch to his Rob for game two, a much heavier character who will typically KO Sheik much earlier than Sheik can KO him. This counter pick seemed to work out perfectly, as Zachary won game two with a three-stock under 100%. At this point, many of us wondered if we'd see a different character from Void, but to our surprise, he stayed with his Sheik pick moving into game three. His persistence paid off, and Void Sheik steamrolled Zachary's Rob, staying on top with combos and frame traps for what felt like the entire game. This trend continued into game four, as did the matchup, and Void's flashy yet optimal combo game drew many new eyes to Smash Ultimate's heavily slept on Sheik. Void won the set 3-1, defeating the 7th best player in the world with solo Sheik. Alright, so what made Sheik drop off so much from Smash 4, and what was Void doing to compensate for this? Well, even in Smash 4, Sheik was a character with amazing frame data and combos, but very low KO power. She was able to make up for this by dominating the neutral game and relying on kill confirms and edge guards to close out stocks. Pretty much all her throw confirms are gone in Ultimate, and her kill power is just as weak, if not weaker. To make matters worse, Smash Ultimate singles game have a damage multiplier, so everyone's attacks deal more damage. Since this increase is calculated with the multiplication of the original damage value, characters with low damage moves benefit far less than high damage characters. Sheik being one of the lowest damage output characters to begin with hardly sees any difference, with moves like forward air dealing as little as 4 damage. If you compare Sheik to a character like Palutena, it takes Sheik twice or even 3 times as many attacks to rack up the same amount of damage in a combo, and Palutena's combos are more consistent as well. Even when she's able to deal tons of damage, Sheik's attacks are pathetically weak, only finding average high percent kills with up air close to the blast zone, forward smash at the ledge, bouncing fish off stage, or a tipper up smash. Besides the tipper up smash, which is her one actually strong kill move, all these KO options require the opponent to be very close to the appropriate blast zone, and they tend to be her more committal attacks as well. Sheik doesn't just struggle to KO, however. She's also among the lightest characters in the game, so any mistake can be extremely punishing. She doesn't have much range either, so she'll need to get up close and personal, where trades are most likely to occur. Smash Ultimate's general mechanic changes also hurt Sheik. In Smash 4, Sheik has one of the best neutral games thanks to her low landing lag and nimble mobility. In Ultimate, every character has pretty low landing lag, so they can play safer around Sheik. Also, Ultimate's dash dancing makes it much harder for Sheik to outmaneuver opponents as she had in Smash 4, and increase the unpredictable factor that may lead to an early stock loss for light characters such as Sheik. Sheik's archetype in Smash 4 and Ultimate makes her a character who excels with the lead, but struggles to make comebacks. With Ultimate being played with 3 stocks instead of 2, opponents can pull a lead further and further away from Sheik when she falls behind. As for Void's optimization of Sheik, he used tons of creativity in his combos to stay on top of Zach Grey and played an extremely safe neutral as well. Void's combos made excellent use of Sheik's up air drag downs. By fast falling in up air as the opponent is caught in its multi-hits, Sheik can access many unique follow-ups. On the ground, she can combo into a grab or tilt to continue the combo for more damage, or at kill percent, a down or forward smash to close out stocks at the ledge. If Sheik is below the platform, she can combo drag down, up air, into a tipper up smash, much like Joker. This combo is particularly notable as it sets up for Sheik's most powerful KO move. Void demonstrated that even when his opponent was able to air dodge the drag down up air, he had time to frame trap and punish the air dodge. These combos and their frame trap opportunities are essentially effective against big body characters with poor disadvantage states, indicating that optimized Sheik may perform well in these matchups despite the KO power differential. In the neutral game, Void made sure to take advantage of Sheik's needles, constantly pressuring Zach Grey to approach him. Despite her speed and frame data, approaching with Sheik carries a high risk. Coupled with her low crouch and crawl, Sheik does an excellent job at punishing opponents who come to her. We see this a lot with Void's use of down tilt, which even combos into tipper up smash and can be micro spaced thanks to Sheik's crawl. In close quarter situations, Void also makes use of Sheik's tilt to carefully pressure shields from a safe distance. Overall, Void plays Sheik's neutral in a very low risk fashion, which is essentially given how much more Sheik needs to hit the opponent than her opponent needs to hit her. This is probably Sheik's biggest win in Ultimate so far, but even so, Void wasn't able to make top 8 in the tournament, let alone win it. It's fun to talk about characters' hidden potentials, but at the end of the day, Sheik is still lacking in many areas. What would Sheik really need to be top tier in this game? Well, let's start with the most obvious factors, damage and knockback. If Sheik's aerials and tilts were adjusted to do closer to 7-8% each, but still combo as they do now, she'd have a combo game more similar to the most existing top tiers in Ultimate, and opening at early percents could consistently lead to 50 or 60% instead of 20 or 30. Sheik's archetype would be a bit OP with tons of kill power, but she could definitely use a lot more. I mean, Joker has more kill power than Sheik with a similar moveset, and he gets Arson. Sheik's kill power can be improved in a few ways. Her combo tools could become KO moves at higher percents by increasing knockback growth and decreasing the base knockback. Alternatively, her main combo moves could be untouched, and moves like back air, up air, forward smash, and down smash could receive more knockback, giving her more power where she's already using it for kills. She could also gain more kill confirms. This could come from a throw into up air combo, like she originally had in Smash 4, lower lag on up air to make drag downs more consistent, or more ways to combo into up smash, such as adjusted angles on down tilt, down air, and neutral air. We certainly don't need Sheik living as long as Bowser, but a few units of weight added would go a long way. Sheik isn't the easiest character to catch, so surviving one strong hit might give her time to make up much more progress with that stock. Increasing the range on needles might give you bad flashbacks from early Smash 4, but ways for Sheik to force approaches and deal damage from a distance would be great if her damage output just isn't increased. Needles could also be used to start combos and edgeguard, so this change would have many positive effects. Whether she's buffed or not, Sheik needs representation in tournaments for her meta to develop. Void's performance at Frostbite sends an excellent message to Sheik players or those who consider picking her up that the character is not as unviable as her reputation implies. So tell us, what do you think of Sheik? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to Pro Guides and click the bell to keep up with more Smash content.